Hi there. Hi. Welcome to my yoga channel. And if you are here for the first time, check all the other videos, all the practice I put there for you. And if you wish to make a contribution, make a donation, you will find a PayPal link on my channel, most of the videos, and also homepage of the channel. And what we're doing today is a practice that you can do every day, and it's for everyone. Huh? So what we have to keep in mind while practicing yoga is to keep your practice safe, to practice safe. That's important, to breathe, to pay attention to the breath, and what the body needs, as I already told you in other videos, those videos during my quarantine in Spain, what the body needs every day, the spine needs every day, the movement of a twist, both sides, a side stretch, a side bend, a back bend, and a forward bend. And based on this principle of moving your spine, you can create your own practice with simple, basic asanas. They function very well for everyone. So today we're starting in a standing position. So let's stand with the feet hip apart, at least. Yeah, take distance between your feet. Open your fingers, your toes. Open your toes really wide, so really feeling your feet grounded. And let's take a deep breath. Bring your arms up. Breathe in, elongate your trunk. Reach up, fingertips to the ceiling and the sternum. And as you breathe out, bend your knees a little bit and you go all the way down, bending forward. Relax your head. Here you can also grab your elbows or your forearms with the opposite hand. And slowly you can feel the back of the legs and also the lumbar area and decide if you want to straighten your legs a little bit more. As you start breathing very consciously through your nose. Otherwise, you can keep your knees slightly bent in order to release tension from the back. And breathe. Five long, deep breaths. Long exhalation and a deep inhalation. And really feeling your breath on your back, next to your spine, the sacrum area, opening up this area of space behind the navel. Your head totally relaxed, your face totally relaxed. Just feeling that gravity. Two more breaths, long and deep. And breathe out next time. Release the position of your arms and you start raising your chest and your head connected to the spine. Place your hands on the top of your knees and push your trunk up. Extend your arms, arch gently forward, breathe in. Arch backwards, breathe out. And continue for a few more times. Breathe in, arch forward, breathe out, arch back. Feel that your navel is going in towards your spine as you breathe out. And your navel is coming out as you breathe in. Breathe out. At the end of the exhalation, pull the navel in and up. Contract a little bit more. And release. Breathe in. Open your chest. Arch forward. Breathe out. Hold your breath outside for 1 second. Pull the navel in and up towards the spine. Release and breathe in, arch forward. Breathe out one more time. Hold your breath outside. Pull the navel in and up. And release, breathe in. Now, as you breathe out, extend your legs, bring your hands to the waist, and send your shoulders, your elbows back, and the hips slightly forward. Lift the sternum, breathe in, up to the top of your chest. Breathe out, look forward, bend your knees a little bit, bring your arms forward and up. Breathing in, look at your feet in a small chair pose. Knees in the same line with the ankles. Elongate your trunk, one more breath. And as you breathe out, bend forward. This time you place your hands on the floor and take 2 steps. Go into downward facing dog. Find the distance you need between your feet and your hands in order to elongate the trunk by that action with the hips, pulling back and up. Relax your head. Breathe long and deep, creating more space. Feeling the muscles right below the navel contracted, pull it in, pelvic floor, lower belly. A gentle ujjayi breath you can always use. And the next breathing, we go to a plank pose. Breathe in. Breathe out, let's stay for a moment. Let's connect everything, the hips, the chest, the trunk, the legs, the tight muscles. And breathe out, controlling the movement. Touch your knees down to the floor. Start bending your elbows next to your trunk and lower your chest and chin. Point your feet. Drop your hips, roll your shoulders back, come to small cobra, breathe in. Breathing out, let's go down the belly. And you place your elbows right under your shoulders, maybe a little bit more in front, so you don't get stuck here, so that you cannot open your chest. Now you take the space. Press your forearms on the floor, pointing your feet, your legs also working. Lift the chest, send your shoulders back and down. Breathe. Keep your neck long. Another breath up to the top of the chest, really feeling that stretch in the front part of the body. Breathe in, breathe out, down to the floor and bring your hands next to your chest. Roll your shoulders back, come up to cobra again. It's going to be different now, the feeling. Check it out. And breathe out. We're moving back to downward facing, knees and toes, and push your mat away from you. Stretch again. Open your mouth once, exhale from the back of your throat. One more time. Exhale. Come up on your toes, breathe in, breathing out. Let's step forward. Let's bring the feet together in front of the yoga mat. Big toes together, breathe in, elongate your spine and your neck. Maybe with the fingertips touching the floor, maybe touching the shin bones. Just don't push back. Continue to elongate forward. Breathe out, bend forward. Drop your head, bend your knees, sit back. Swing your arms off, breathe in. Breathe out, look at your feet, you can see your toes. Keep elongating your trunk. Legs together, knees together, feet together. Pull yourself all the way up, breathe in. Lift the sternum, extend your legs, breathe out, arms along the trunk. One moment here, and you pay attention to the breath rhythm and to your posture, standing. Bring your hands to your waist, bend your knees a little bit, and step back with your right foot. Let's say you're doing like me, with the left foot in front and the right foot behind, the same line, and always that position of the back foot with the toes slightly in, front foot always pointing forward, taking off distance, and rotate your trunk to the right side. Keep that position of the feet. Now let's go with the arms in the same line with the shoulders, breathe in. Reach forward, the left side of the trunk over the left leg, breathe out. Triangle, pose, side, bend. We stay five. Now check your alignment. As you're breathing, you're working also on your alignment and balance. We have some balance here. Everything in the same line. Take another deep breath. Now bring your right arm next to your head and extend a little bit more the right side of your trunk. Breathe in. Breathe out, bend your front leg and swing your trunk up to the second warrior. Now, important to adjust the position of the pelvis, the hips. They shouldn't be like this, they should be like that. So we have the trunk, the head, the pelvis always in the same line and the front knee pointing forward. Let's stay, lift the chest. Keep both arms working and the hands to the fingertips stretch, pulling away from you. One more breath. Long and deep breathing. With the next inhalation, bring your left arm up. Drop your right arm, touching your back leg. Breathe in deeply. Breathe out, left hand outside of the foot, right hand inside of the foot. Return the back foot. Press your toes on the floor, five toes. Keep your back leg straight and the front knee bent. And rotate to the left side. So you rotate against your front leg, five. Breathing, two, one, exhale, hands to the floor, push the mat away from you, step back, left foot to downward facing and stretch, just feel it for a moment, If you feel different left and right side, and we go forward to the plank pose, breathe in, hold on all together, breathe out, lower the body directly, or knees, chest, chin. Breathe in, cobra without forcing. Just finding that space. Breathe out, back to downward facing stretch. Let's walk forward again. Step, walk, feet together. Breathe in, elongate your spine and neck. Breathe out, bend forward. Drop your head, bend your knees. Sit, chair pose, breathe in. Arms up, breathe out, sit a little bit deeper, sink a little bit deeper, look at your feet, legs together, feet together, knees together, push all the way up, breathe in, breathe out, standing. Check the feeling, standing pose, the breath rhythm. Bring your hands to your waist. Bend a little bit your knees. Step back with your left foot. Let me change here. Left foot. Take the distance you need and the line of the feet. Arms in the line with the shoulders. Lift the chest. Here, yes, you can send your hips back as you reach forward towards your front leg, touch gently, stay five, breathing deeply in, really feeling the energy that flows from the center of the body here, around the navel, throughout the whole body. And let's increase a little bit the stretch on the left side of the trunk by pulling the left arm next to the head. Take another breath. Breathe out. Bend your front knee and come up to the second warrior, Virabhadrasana. And adjust the position of the hip. Front knee pointing straight forward. We stay, lift the heart. Make sure both hands, arms are working, pulling away from you. And you look to the fingertips, to the hand in front of you. One more breath. Breathe out, breathe in next time. Right arm up, left arm, left hand touching your back leg. Take a deep, long breath. Breathe out. Next time, right hand outside of the foot, left hand inside of the foot, and we rotate the left leg in. Press the five toes on the floor and we start to rotate into the other side. Keep your back leg working. Quadriceps, thigh, muscle. Keep elongating from the back foot to the crown of your head and rotating. Two more. So we take at least five breaths. One. Breathe out. Hands to the floor. Push right foot back. And we hear again a Dukha stretch. Pull your hips back and off the sitting bones. Feeling both sides. And come to plank pose. Breathe in. Breathe out, lower the body if you wish. First the knees, then chest and chin, keeping your elbows close to your body. Point your feet, drop your hips, come up to cobra. Breathe in, take your time. Open your chest, breathe out. Push back to downward facing. And open your mouth again once or twice. Exhale. Let's go forward from here. Step, walk, feet together. Breathe in, elongate. Breathe out, bend forward. Drop your head, bend your knees. Sitting on that chair, breathe in, swing your arms. Breathe out, sit. Keep up. And come all the way up, breathe in, pull your chest up, breathe out, standing. Just feeling for a moment. Hands to the waist. And again, we bend a little bit the knees and we go with the right foot behind the buttock muscle. Grab the foot with your right hand and go back with that knee, with that leg, with the shoulder on the right side. Send it back, pelvis forward, left arm in front. You can also press the foot back against your hand and you lean forward a little bit. And keep your eyes just looking at the same point. Stay there just for a few breaths. You don't have to go up, up, up with the foot. You can stay here also with the foot, with the knee a little bit lower. Just don't let the knee going in front and you collapsing here. Think about opening this line in front of the body. Breathe out. Next time, bring your right knee towards your chest, standing. Pull with both hands. Elongate the spine, the crown of the head, up to the ceiling. Flex your foot. Keep your knee in the same line with the hip joint and rotate to your right side. You can touch your leg with the opposite hand while you pull the opposite arm, the right arm, back. Take another breath. Breathe out. Come back to the center. Place both feet together. Take a deep breath. Breathe in. Breathe out, bend gently to your left side, legs together and straight. Breathe in, up. Breathe out, bend gently to your right side. Breathe in, back to the center. Breathe out, palms to the chest, hands to the waist. Left side, let's go there with the left foot. And let's do the same. Send the hips forward as you send that left knee, left shoulder back. Right arm straight and your eyes focus on one point and don't hold your breath. Keep it flowing. And you can explore different variations if you like. You can press that foot behind you. You can keep your standing leg a little bit bent. You can keep it straight. Explore. Breathe out next time. Bring your left knee to your chest. Flex your foot. growing up towards the city. From here, bring the knee in the same line with the hip joint. And let's rotate to the left side. Keep the breath flowing. Breathe out. Slowly come back forward. Feet together. From here, arms up, breathe in. Elongate, breathe out, gently to the right side. Breathe in, up, breathe out, gently to the left. Breathe in, lift the chest. Breathe out, arms from the side, and we're bending forward. So we did also balance. The practice is complete now. We're going to the floor to do some of the last poses. Prepare, breathing in, elongate. Bend your knees, place your hands on the floor. Two steps to plank, breathing out, going down. Directly or knees, chest and chin. Cobra, how is your cobra now? Breathe out. How is your downward facing dog now? How much space you got? And freedom to breathe. Breathe out. Next time. Knees to the floor. And let's rest here for a moment. Bring your legs forward. Lay down on your back and pull your knees towards your chest. Breathe out. Breathe in up to the top of your chest. Breathe out, pulling the knees, pressing your belly gently. Relaxing your lower back. Now, one more pose, very important, Hatha Yoga pose. Very good for the body, very good for the immune system. Let's place the feet on the floor, hip apart. Arms along the trunk. Spread your toes. Push your feet on the floor, come up with the hips, breathe in. Breathe out, allow your shoulders to move away from your neck. Lift the chest towards the chin, press the chin in. If you like, you can interlace your fingers behind your back. Arms straighten, press your arms, your hands towards the floor, against the floor. Shoulder blades are coming together towards each other, and we lift a little bit more the body. Breathe in the middle of your chest. And with the next exhalation, release the position of the hands, take another breath up to the top of the chest, the middle of the chest, and breathing out, you start rolling slowly down, vertebra by vertebra, sacrum, touch the floor, you pull the knees again, this time pull the knees towards your armpits, to the sides. Press the sacrum down to the floor. Breathe out. Knees together. Circles with the legs together. Circles both sides, left and right. And you can take a gentle twist here with the legs together to one side, keeping your shoulders on the floor. Relaxing even more the lower back area. Breathe out, breathe in, come back up, center, and then you just go to the other side. Both legs, keep your shoulder blades on the floor. Breathing in, up to the top of the chest. Breathing out, down to the lower back area. Releasing that tension you don't need. Long exhalation, deep inhalation. Breathe in, next time, come back. Breathe out, center your hips and rest in Sutta Baddha Konasana with the sole of the feet together, touching knees, opening to the sides. It elongates the trunk, arms above the head. Grab your forearms or your elbows. Relax. Close your eyes, relax your face muscles, relax the abdominal muscles, pelvic floor. Let the breath flow easily through your nose, in and out. Stay there for a moment, resting, and I hope you enjoy the practice today. See you next time, probably on Monday. Please subscribe if you didn't yet. Recommend to your friends, yogis. Big kiss, bacioni a tutti.